Well, the last few weeks since the devastating terror attack in Christchurch has made us challenge who we are as a nation, our own views towards different people, different religions, and reflect on race relations in Aotearoa.
It's quite timely then that today an exhibition opens in Ōtara called Dawn Raids and reflects on a horrendous time in New Zealand's history when Pasifika people were singled out for their race and injustices occurred. It was a dark time for race relations, and joining us today is Tigilau Ness, whakalawhalahia atu, and also Will Ilolahia, mālo lelei. Tigi, I'll start with you. Now, the exhibition is called Educate to Liberate. In light of Christchurch, how important is it that we don't forget about Dawn Raids?
Well, mainly that when things are not right, you can stand up for your rights. Like the immigration Dawn Raids that was happening there, if we hadn't have protested and did certain things, action about it, it would have been swept under and gone on probably till, you know, forever.
Well, do you have, what's your most vivid memory of that time of the Dawn Raids or your involvement with the Polynesian Panthers?
It was probably some of the members coming up and saying they were picked up on the streets. And, you know, we were New Zealand born. And the vivid thing for me was that I had to make a decision. So we called all the captains of the chapters to come in and make a decision about what we're going to do about this. We had already existed for 5 years by then, and so we were getting also flack from the community to do something about it.
Yeah. What about now? How far do you think our Pasifika community has come as a migrant community?
Leaps and bounds. We're very much to the fore of the community, the population in Aotearoa. Even though we're a minority still, that'll change as well. I mean, we're New Zealand Aotearoa, born and bred now. We're very much part of life.
Do you think the fact that we are very much part of New Zealand life, as you say, you know, many of our Pasifika community are third generation New Zealanders, has it made Pacific people, I guess, more complacent as migrants, I guess, towards other groups or race relations? Well, what do you think?
Yeah, I think it's concerning, actually, because, you know, when we came over here as migrants, you know, this is a nation of migrants, after all. Mm. You know, we were receiving some of the flack that I think some of our new migrants are receiving. And now that we've settled into New Zealand, I would say that a significant number of our people are becoming Islamophobic, which is a concern for me, because, you know, well, a concern for us, because we put our life on the line to make this country a really good place, and I think we have. But these little areas need to be sorted, and what's hurting me anyway is that it's my own people, our own people that are actually perpetuating the situation of why Christchurch happened.
Yeah. Now, Dawn Raids, we've seen some footage on screen, the black and white footage of, you know, during that time, and now it's part of NCEA here in New Zealand, it's part of the curriculum. You both have been speaking at schools. What are your messages for the youth of today, Tingi?
That it's okay to stand up and speak out if things aren't right, or, you know, it's all about human rights, and that they, children, looking at the history and what we've done and accomplished, they can do the same, not to be afraid to have a voice, to speak out.
You both and the Polynesian Panthers did some amazing things, and I sense there was a lot of anger at the injustices. What about now? Where are the new Polynesian Panthers, or the new generation? Speaking out against some of the injustices we see now.
Yeah, I mean, you know, there was a little group called the Pacific Panthers that tried to start up, and but which I learned today, that the brother here had made a statement that once you're a Panther, you're always a Panther, and now we're stuck. You know, we can't retire. So we basically still carry on with the things, and, you know, adapted to the present. What we try and encourage our people, well, all kids that come to these classes, these Panther rap classes we have, is that we encourage them that education is a ticket out, and we encourage them to stand up for themselves, and make this place a better place than what we try to do.
Well, thank you, Will, and thank you, Tigilau, for both coming on the show. Do get along and have a look at the Dawn Raids exhibition. It's happening at Otara. Also, there's a poetry night happening, Poetry for the People, next Thursday as well.
Yeah, and you're speaking today at 1 till about 2, I think?
Yes, at the Fresh Gallery.
Fantastic.
In Otara.
Okay. All right.